indeed. From his arm and pin he sent his peers a pirate now indeed.
Here's good luck to Bailey's Ventures, Bailey's out of his adventures.
2 and 20 now he's rising, and along he's fit to fly, which we're bent on signalizing with unusual rebel rhyme.
Here's good luck to Bailey's Ventures, Bailey's out of his.
The brave black flag I fly, and pay a sanctimonious part for the pirate head and the pirate heart. Away to the cheating world go you, where pirates all are well to do, but I'll be true to the song I sing, and live and die a pirate king. For I am a pirate king, and it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king, for I am a pirate king.
You are the pirate king.
And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king.
It is the pirate king.
When I sally forth to seek my prey, I help myself in a royal way. I sink a few more ships in tune than a well-bred monarch ought to do. But many a king on a first-class throne, if he wants to call his crown his own, must manage somehow to get through more dirty work than ever I do. For I am a pirate king, And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king. For I am a pirate king.
Oh, a pirate king.
And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king.
It is a pirate king.
Put up the pirate king.
Oh, false one, you have deceived me.
I have deceived you.
Yes, deceived me. You told me you were fair as gold.
And master, I thought so.
And now I see you're plain and old.
I'm sure I'm not a jost.
Upon my innocence you play.
I'm not the one to plot so.
Your face is lined, your hair is gray.
It's gradually got so.
Faithless woman, do deceive me. I who trusted so.
Master, master, do not leave me. Hear me ere you go.
Faithless woman.
Master, master.
Faithless woman.
Master, master. Do not leave me. Do not leave me.
Hear me ere you go.
Master, woman, do not leave me.
Hear me ere.
Before these gentle maidens, I dare not show in this alarming costume. No, no, I must remain in close concealment until I can appear in decent clothing.
Greet them gaily as they
I had intended not to intrude myself upon your notice in this effective but alarming costume. But under these peculiar circumstances, it is my bounden duty to inform you that your proceedings will not be unwitnessed.
But who are you, sir? Speak.
I am a pirate.
A pirate? Ha!
Ladies, do not shun me. This evening I renounce my vile profession. And to that end, O pure and peerless maidens, O blushing buds of ever-blooming beauty, I sore at heart, implore your kind assistance.
How pitiful his tale, how rare his beauty.
Oh, is there not one maiden breast which doth not feel the moral beauty of making worldly interest subordinate to sense of duty? Who would not give up willingly all matrimonial ambition to rescue such an one as I from his unfortunate position, from his position, to rescue such an one as I from his unfortunate position.
Alas, there's not one maiden breast which seems to feel the moral beauty or think it would impress subordinate to sense of
and bad complexion have caused all home to disappear of ever winning man's affection. To such an one, if such there be, I swear by heaven large above you, if you will cast your eyes on me, however plain you I love you, however plain you be. If you will cast your eyes on me, however plain you be, I love you. Senses, men who stick at no offences will anon be here. Piracy, their dreadful trade is. Pray you get you hence, young ladies, while the coast is clear.
Thank you. of virtuity, to be married with impunity, and indulge in the felicity of one parted to miss his scheme. You shall quickly be personified, come get an entry modified by a doctor of divinity who is located in this vicinity.
General.
For he is the Major General.
He is for after the Major General.
And it is a glorious thing to be a Major General.
It is for after the Major General, for after the Major General.
Very model of a modern Major General. I have information, vegetable, animal, and mineral. I know the kings of England like to quote the Fudge Historical from Marathon to Waterloo in order categorical. I'm very well acquainted, too, with matters mathematical. I understand equations both the simple and quadratical. About binomial theorem, I am teeming with a lot of news. Lot of news. With many cheerful facts about the square of the hypotenuse.
Many cheerful facts about the square of the hypotenuse. Many cheerful facts about the square of the hypotenuse. Many cheerful facts about the square of the hypotenuse.
I'm very good at integral and differential calculus. I know the scientific names of beings animalculous. In short, in matters vegetable, animal, and mineral, I am the very model of a modern Major General.
In short, in matters vegetable, animal, and mineral, he is the very model of a modern Major General.
I know our mythic history, King Arthur's answer paradox. I answer hard acrostics, I repeat a taste of paradox. I quote an elegiac, all the crimes of Heliogabalus. In Koenigsegg, I can flaunt peculiarities parabolous. I can tell undoubted Raphael's from Gerard Dawson's offenies. I know the croaking chorus from the frogs of Aristophanes. Then I can hum a fugue of which I've heard the music's dinner for. Dinner for. Ah, and whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense pinafore.
Whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense pinafore. Whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense pinafore. Whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense pinafore.
Then I can write a washing bill in Babylonic cuneiform and give you every detail of Caractacus's uniform. In short, and matters vegetable, animal, and mineral, I am the very model of a modern Major General. In fact, when I know what is meant by mammalon and ravelin, when I can tell at sight a mouse a rifle from a javelin, when such affairs are sorties and surprises I'm more wary at, and when I know precisely what is meant by commissariat, when I have learnt what progress has been made in modern gunnery, when I know more of tactics than a novice in a nunnery, in short, when I've a smattering of elemental strategy. I have it. You'll say a better Major General has never sat a G. Of a military knowledge, though I'm plucky and adventurous, has only been brought down to the beginning of the century. But still, in matters vegetable, animal, and mineral, I am the very model of a modern Major General.
And a dismal fate. Forgo your cruel employ. Have pity on my lonely state. I am an orphan boy.
An orphan boy.
An orphan boy. Children whom you see are all that I can call my own.
Poor fellow.
Take them away from me, and I shall be indeed alone.
Poor fellow.
If pity you can feel, leave me my soul remaining joy. See at your feet they kneel, your hearts you cannot steal. Against the sad, sad tale of the lonely orphan boy.
Poor fellow.
They would have taken my daughters over the billowy waters if I hadn't in elegant diction indulged in an innocent fiction, which is not in the same category as telling a regular terrible story. Is a useful thing to be an orphan boy.
It is the lovely orphan boy, the lovely orphan boy.
Oh, happy day, with joyous thing, we will away and marry me.
Oh, happy day, with joyous thing, we will away and marry me.
Should it be for us vicious if our sisters all will fight with me?
Sisters all will fight with me.
did deceive me.
Now pray you did deceive him.
Oh, do not leave me.
Oh, do not leave her.
Away, you grieve me.
Away, you grieve him.
I wish you'd leave me.
We wish you'd leave him. We love the magnanimity, we display to lay sentimenty. Never was an opportunity to get married with impunity. But a gift of the felicity, of unbounded domesticity, the doctor of divinity is located in this vicinity.
Thank you.
Frederick, let your escort lion-hearted be summoned to receive a general's blessing ere they depart upon their dread adventure.
Dear sir, may come.
Bears his steel.
The
uncomfortable feel.
Surrender.
And we find the wisest thing.
Surrender.
Is to slap our chest and sing.
Surrender.
For when fretting with the mute.
Surrender.
And your heart is in your boots.
Surrender.
There is nothing brings it round like the trumpet's martial sound, like the trumpet's martial sound. Highly nervous state. Still to us it evident these attentions are meant.
Go and do your best endeavor, and if all is clever, we will say farewell forever. Go to glory and to
distress on the wrist and on his press, and of reverence a lack to our chance of coming back. Still, perhaps it would be wise not to cop or criticize, for it's very evident these attentions are well meant.
Yes, it's very evident these attentions are well meant. Every day, yes, well meant. Every day, ah, yes, well meant.
Now for the pirate's lair. repeated acts of theft and pillage, which had a sense of duty's stern dictation. I, circumstances victim, have been guilty.
Young Frederick,
who called
your late commander,
and I, your little Ruth.
Oh, mad intruders, how dare you face me? Know ye not, oh, rash ones, that I have doomed you to extermination.
Have mercy on us. Hear us, ere you slaughter.
I do not think I ought to listen to you. Yet mercy should alloy us turn resentment. And so I will be merciful. Say on.
We tried to raise our spirits faint, according to our custom old, with quip and quibble quaint. But all in vain the quip we heard, we lay and sobbed upon the rocks, until to somebody occurred a startling paradox.
A paradox!
A paradox, a most ingenious paradox, with quips and quibbles herding flocks, but none to beat this paradox.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox. A paradox!
The curious quips of cranks and contradictions queer, and with the laughter on our lips we wished you there to hear. We said if we could tell it him, how Frederick would the joke enjoy. And so we risked both life and limb to tell it to our boy.
That paradox,
that paradox, that most ingenious paradox, with quips and quibbles heard in flocks, but none to beat that paradox.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox. A paradox.
For some ridiculous reason, to which, however, I have no desire to be disloyal, some person authority, I don't know who, very likely the astronomer royal, has decided that although for such a beastly month as February, 28 days of the rule are plenty, 1 year in every four, his days should be reckoned as 9 and 20. Through some singular coincidence, I shouldn't be surprised if we're owing to the agency of an ill-natured fairy. You are the victim of this clumsy arrangement, having been born in a leap year on the 29th of February. And so, by a simple arithmetical process, you will easily discover that though you have lived 21 years, yet if we go by birthdays, you're only 5 and a little bit over.
Dear me, let's see. Yes, yes, with yours my fingers do agree. How quaint the ways of paradox, at common sense she gaily mocks. Though counting in the usual way years 21 I've been alive, yet reckoning by my natal day, yet reckoning by my natal day. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I am a little boy of five.
He is a little boy of five.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox.
A paradox.
A curious paradox. I've earned his faith, deception to repay. His very denied, a mental star. So glut yourself and go away, away,
away, away. Ere I expire, I find my duty hard to do today. My heart is filled with anguish dire. It strikes me to the core, away, away.
With falsehood foul, he tricks us of our bride. Then vengeance how the parish so decides. our nature stern, he suffered with his lies, and in return tonight the traitor dies.
Yes, tonight the traitor dies.
Tonight he dies.
Yes, on early tomorrow.
His girls likewise.
They will wait for in sorrow.
The one shot for.
In their nature they cherish.
And all who plot.
To a music shall perish.
Tonight he dies. Yes, on early tomorrow. His girls likewise. They will wait for in sorrow. The one shot for. In their nature they cherish. And all but to a music shall perish.
Away, away,
away.
Tonight the play.
To serve a pirate captain until I reach my 21st birthday.
But you're 21.
I've just discovered that I was born in leap year, and that birthday will not be reached by me till 1940.
Oh, horrible catastrophe appalling.
And so farewell.
No, no, afraid we feel this. Their tropics say they have no legal claim. No shadow of a shame will fall upon my name. Their tropics say.
I quit these walls, the thought my soul appalls, but when stern duty calls, I must obey.
Nay,
Mabel,
nay,
but duty's name, the thought my soul appalls, but when stern duty calls,
where nature day by day will.
in 1940 I of age shall be, I'll then return and claim you, I declare it.
It seems so long.
Swear that till then you will be true to me.
Your hand is strong. My old friend is dead and gone, I swear it.
So here is love, and here is truth. And here is proof of joy and love. She will be faithful to her truth. Till we are well and even after. So here is love and here is truth. She will be faithful to her truth. Till we are well and even after. And even after. So here is love and here is truth. And here is proof of joy and love. She will be faithful to her truth. She will be faithful to her soul till we are wed and even after, even after. For here is love and here is hope. For here is love.
That's behind.
Tarantula.
Yet when the danger's near,
Tarantula, Tarantula.
We manage to appear,
Tarantula.
As insensible to fear as anybody here, as anybody here.
Tarantula, 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 Tarantula.
When a felon's not engaged in his employment,
his employment,
or maturing his felonious little plans,
little plans,
his capacity for innocent enjoyment,
enjoyment,
is just as great as any honest man's.
Honest man's.
Our feelings we with difficulty smother,
but he smother,
when constabulary duties to be done,
to be done.
Take one consideration with another,
with another.
A policeman lot is not a happy one.
Oh, when constabulary duties to be done, a policeman's lot is not a happy one.
Enterprising burglars, not a burgling.
Not a burgling.
When the cutthroat isn't occupied in crime,
crime.
He loves to hear the little brook a gurgling.
Brook a gurgling.
And listen to the merry village chime.
Village chime.
When the coster's finished jumping on his mother.
On his mother.
He loves to lie up basking in the sun.
In the sun.
Take one consideration with another.
With another.
A policeman's lot is not a nappy one.
Oh, when constabulary duties to be done, a policeman's lot is not a happy one.
Tired of tossing on the sea, I'll try your head at a burglary.
hush, I hear them on the manor poaching. With stealthy steps the pirates are approaching.
We are not coming from play to go, a story General Stanley told. Receive a penalty 54 for General Stanley's story.
They seek a penalty
54, receive a penalty
54.
Receive a penalty 54 for General Stanley's story.
They come in force with stealthy stride. Our obvious course is now to hide.
Inside, the Major General comes, so quickly hide.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes. Tormented with the anguished dread of falsehood unatoned, I lay upon my sleepless bed and tossed and turned and groaned. The man who finds his conscience ache, no peace at all enjoys. And as I lay in bed awake, I thought I heard a noise.
He thought he heard a noise.
Arthur!
No, all is still in dale on hill. My mind is set at ease. So still the scene, it must have been the sighing of the breeze. Softly to the river comes the loving breeze.
setting nature all a quiver, rustling through the trees. And the brook in rippling measure laughs for very love, while the poplars in their pleasure wave their arms above.
Summon your men and effect their capture.
Frederick, save us!
Beautiful Mabel, I would if I could, but I am not able.
He's telling the truth, he is not able.
With base deceit, you worked upon our feelings. Revenge is sweet and favors all our dealings. With courage rare and resolution manly, for death prepare unhappy General Stanley.
Is he to die and shriven at an ill?
Who shall he?
When no one in his cause a weapon wields?
Who shall he?
Yes, we are here, though hither to conceal.
Advantage you've contrived, but your proud triumph will not be long-lived. Don't say you're orphans, for we know that game. On your allegiance we've a strong acclaim. We charge you yield. We charge you yield in Queen Victoria's name.
You
do.
They all know me from the common road.
man unmoved that statement hears. Because with all our faults, we love our House of Peers. I pray you pardon me, ex-pirate king. Peers will be peers, and youth will have its fling. Resume your ranks and legislative duties, and take my daughters, all of whom are beauties.
Wandering ones, we have surely strayed. Take heart of grace, your steps retrace. Wandering ones, if such poor love as ours can help you find trophies of fame, I take